I can think of younger days when living for my life was everything a man could want to do.
We're not quite sure where we are. We're in the city of Manchester right now, but we're not quite sure whereabouts in the city we are. We're on our way to Withington Road.
Wally Range.
Wally Range. Which was the first house we lived in
right.
when we first came to Manchester from the Isle of Man.
And the first nursery school. The
first nursery school.
That me and Morris went to,
yeah,
when,
right.
I called him Woggy.
Yes, and you were Bodding.
And he called me Bodding.
You were Bodding and I was Baz.
That's
I
right.
I was Baz. Yeah.
Yeah.
And those were our nicknames. You turn left here.
Move
the old chip
it's
shop.
It's Longford Road.
We should line up at the chip shop
yes.
here.
And the news agency where we used to buy the Dandy yeah. and the Beano.
Yeah, sorry. Okay, if you drive down here, this was our school.
Yeah, this hasn't changed at all, this is the same. The school we used to go to and...
Yes.
It's the old playground, remember it?
Yes.
Very vividly. Has guard dogs in it now.
Yeah. Something's changed.
Didn't have guard dogs when we were in it. Mr. Jones was the headmaster. I don't know where he is, but...
Have you seen my wife, Mr. Jones? Do you know what it's like on the outside? Don't go talking too loud, you'll cause a landslide, Mr. Jones.
So, driver, it's Sean Kamadi, Keppel Road. If you will.
That's it, slow down now. Yeah, Keppel Road, to your right.
Yeah, go right.
Yeah.
Because that's the allotments up there, we don't have
yeah, yeah, allotments there. This was our...
This is very familiar.
This is where what you would call our music
yeah.
was born.
This is where... For real.
This is where we first started. Influenced by others, obviously, but the first time we ever sang together was in this street.
You got run over by a car, right?
I got hit by a car here, yeah. And... On that corner is where we used to play and hope to get discovered, which didn't happen.
Yeah, we used to look for talents, talent scouts we used to look for.
Yeah.
But we had this image of talent scouts looking like scouts. A uniform, shorts and big hat,
yeah. Yeah, but if you've got the patience to walk with us for a second, walk with us for a second, Rob.
Just don't get struck by lightning.
Wow, Kenny Barber. And his family. Eric Briggs was right here where the alleyway is.
Yeah. These are our old friends.
And if he follows down here, this is what life is like behind all these houses. And it's another life. It's another way of life for children because parents weren't around. And if you follow us to the end here, you'll see what we mean.
All of this area, this is where our musical roots began. Right here in Keppel Road.
Right here. Okay. Now you shoot as far down there as you can. You shoot as far down there as you can.
The old alleyways.
Yeah.
They almost look nicer today. When they
yeah. These were our alleyways. This is where we played.
Yeah.
This was our world. This was our world when I was about 8 or 9 and Robin and Morris were about 6 or 7.
We were very young to start with.
Yeah.
So you get into music.
But this was our world. There was no adults. And the trouble we used to get into is nobody's business.
With the Barbers, who used to live in this house? Didn't
well, there was Florence Barber. Florence Barber lived here.
Right.
Florence Barber was my first kiss. And she told me that she would kiss me if I went and cleaned my teeth.
Fair enough.
Which I thought was a fair comment. There was the Frost family further down.
Well, they were the only ones out of television, which would go and...
Yes. Kenny Frost.
What's their television?
And Kenny Hart and the Horrocks family.
Most people didn't have a TV in those days. Late 50s, we used to go and sort of watch.
Yeah.
Somebody else's television. We couldn't afford a TV.
It's crowded.
It's too many cars.
When we were kids, you'd be lucky to see 2 cars in this street. And the street was ours, you know? Now you're in between cars everywhere, you know, and that didn't exist then. That didn't exist then.
But 51 Couple Road, that's where we started.
That's where the music.
That's
began.
Where the music began, because we used to listen to the radio in the basement of that.
Where the disc is.
Yeah. Yeah, where the satellite dish is.
Yes. We used to make our own guitars in the basement.
We challenge ourselves to write.
Yeah.
What the artist?
Well, if it could have been Rock Around the Clock, wherever it was, that was us. That was us. And I think, you know, even though I think it's a bit silly thinking about it now, it was all about kiss curls and hair standing out 3-4 inches from your head. But mainly Kiss Curls, Bill Haley, Rock Around the Clock, Don't Knock the Rock.
Yeah.
Was it?
Butterfly, Guy Mitchell.
All those people. Guy Mitchell, Tommy Steele.
I think the thing
is, this was our life.
I don't think we ever imagined, all this was for fun. We just grew into it. We just never imagined ever doing anything else. Morris got shot in the eye with an air gun, just about here, from there to right here.
And I told Eric Briggs I'd get him for it. He's probably about this, just tall now.
Well, let's forget it.
Remember the air gun?
It was an air Luger, actually, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Morris shot just on the bridge of the eye.
Yeah. And we'd stand in front of the post office, which I don't know what it is now, but that building there with the bars on it, we'd stand there and sing and play and hope that somebody might
discover us.
Might discover us. We weren't discovered.
Barry used to go out on the outside at night and sit on the steps and play a guitar his father made for him out of the bottom of an old cheese barrel with electric wires, you know, the very thin wires. And he'd sit there singing songs he'd written in his own mind. He was only 11. And he'd never lived, so, you know, he'd sing really deep songs. And all the kids in the district used to come out that used to listen to his music.
Just doing what came to
life. Oh, yeah, because every day was our own.
If ever you got a brain in your heart, someone has hurt you and torn you apart.
Afraid to go near it.
Which one?
This gate here.
I just
want to see if there's an iron bar still hanging across the wall.
What, like,
behind the
door?
From it, yeah.
Well, you only can go in.
Well, there's an alarm system there.
Ah. Well, why do you just knock on the front door? See if there's anyone in.
Things don't change, do they? Yeah. Hello.
Hiya, how you doing?
Fine, mate.
My mum's your biggest fan.
Oh, that's very nice. You give her a
No, job. I'm my biggest fan. I'm the biggest fan of you.
Possible to take a quick picture,
are
you
okay
with that?
Yeah, gotta be quick. Yep.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, mate.
Thank you.
All right, guys.
Which way?
And there was Mrs. Burridge.
That's it, yes.
When Leslie got burnt.
Yes.
It was Mrs. Burridge that we went to call the police. Call the ambulance.
Careful, otherwise I might have to call police again.
We used to sit up there firing air pistols to see if we could penetrate these windows.
God!
All right. Farewell, Keppel.
Keppel Road.
To open up your eyes to love.
And of course, with our dad, he did, you know, he was always playing records. Just every Sunday, there'd be a Hollywood song being played around the house, especially in Keppel Road. Yeah. And you could hear it coming through the floorboards, and there's that inspiration, the traditional Hollywood songs that he'd play, and also the songs he'd play on the piano. And he was self-taught, like Barry was self-taught on the guitar. He played piano. We often said to him, why doesn't he compose in later life?
Do you think you guys kind of realised his dream in a way? Because you were very successful.
Well, we hope so. Yeah. Because we think it was his dream. He had his band, and I think he wanted to become famous. I think he wanted his band to become famous. And we made that come true. He made his dream come true through us.
When you were in Keppel Road, did you ever think about Hollywood and all that stuff?
Yeah. We thought of fame.
Yeah.
Whether Hollywood was part of it or somewhere else was, I think it was always about becoming famous.
Yeah.
And we never realised you could actually make a great living from it, you know?
Yeah, it was just somebody liking our songs. It's like the world at large recognising and liking your songs. I think that's what we felt was the driving force. Somebody...
Hollywood was everything to people, kids like us living in Manchester. So many people. I was 58.
It makes you realise the futility of life, you know.
Yeah.
Why? Because we can't control it. It's just when and how.
Yeah.
You know, we're just going.
Is it 6 years since Morris died? Forgive me.
About 5 years.
Yeah. It must have been a real body blow to you two.
It was shattering to both of us. Shattering to both of us in countless ways.
We don't really know how Morris died.
We don't know how Morris died.
Good morning, Mr. Sunshine. You brighten up my day. Come sit beside me in your way.
Got all those songs and I'm passing them all on to the three of us.
Yep.
All the Australian
songs.
These
are your ideas, Andy, yeah. And I never stop thinking of it. Again.
Yeah.
There on a high and windy hill.
Oh, that one.
Fantastic.
No, I'll always remember that. It's the rest of it I don't remember, yeah. But I remember that.
But I can remember. You couldn't just... And I'm playing this section. You had more of Again, and you had a piece of High and Windy Hill.
Right.
There on High and Windy Hill.
Wow.
It's haunting.
What are they doing? Oh, you've got to come over here.
Yeah, these are classics. But they've gone.
You've got to bring the camera over here.